This is a chicken egg, and this is one Minecraft chicken egg. This is the world's largest diamond, and this is one Minecraft diamond.
Do I even need to explain this apple or this spider? Clearly, Minecraft is not exactly properly sized. So let's just explore how absolutely insane these things are and go through every single part of Minecraft and see their size. Now, before we get into these item-looking things, I need to tell you something, because usually the height would be measured by the amount of pixels divided by 16, because the items are in a, like, 16 by 16 grid. However, we have two exceptions. One is that most of these items are, like, 3D-looking, see this sort of 3D effect sort of thing? But what I'm gonna do is just count the total because of, like, perspective distortion. See? If you rotate this bucket, it stays about the same. And also, these are way too big, but in an item frame, the items display at 50% the size. And I have proof to support this. You know when you drop an item and it appears really small? Yeah, that happens to be 50% the size as well. If you've seen my video about the power of Minecraft players, then you will know that these people are absolutely insane. So the main theory is that the food is what's powering them. So for instance, if you take this apple and turn it 3D, it results in a volume of about 45,000 cubic centimeters, whereas a normal apple is about 290 cubic centimeters. The Minecraft carrot is about 9 pixels long, evident by this line, which is about 27 centimeters, and a normal carrot is about 16. Oh yeah, and this cake is square for some reason, and it's almost 3 feet wide, and with a height of 8 pixels, that results in 100 gallons of cake, which is a lot. And this bowl can hold about 12 gallons of liquid, and this cookie is 1 foot wide, and this potato is 3 gallons, the bread is 1 foot long, and yeah, I think that's all I'm gonna cover in this section because I don't want a video to be an hour long. Each block is 1 meter long, and this fact is known to be true by basically everyone. Most of the things are okay size, like the log, dirt, stone, and leaves. It works. But others, not so much. There was this one thing I saw, where each item gets apparently one tiny little voxel in the chest. And yeah, the math works out there, but that means that this chest's contents are very compressed. Let's observe the stone button for a second. With a voxel count of 48 and a total of 4,096 voxels per block, you get a button that's 1 foot long, 10 inches tall, and 5 inches thick. This results in almost 12,000 cubic centimeters, which with the density of stone leads to 36 kilograms. And using the work equation and knowing that a human can produce about 1,500 newtons, it would take about 44 joules just to push in the button. And for context, each step you take is about 0.5 joules. However, the coral blocks are also extremely big, and while it can technically grow to that size, usually it doesn't. And these frog eggs are just a little big, especially compared to the 1 millimeter size they are in real life. The cacti are both taller and wider than the normal cacti by about 2.5. And guessing from this picture, it looks like the watermelon is about a meter long, and probably like 0.35 meters thick. And that would make the Minecraft watermelon about 2 times heavier than the world record. And that's about it for this section. At this point of researching, I was kind of surprised to find that most of the blocks were properly sized, but that all changed when I got to the mobs. I first started at the axolotl, which is the first real one, and thankfully the wiki had this cool feature where it shows you how big the mob is, but it's inaccurate, and it's actually about 162 centimeters, which you can find by just counting the pixels, then dividing by 16. And I compared this to the real value, which is... what? 23 centimeters? Anyways, the bat was also kind of annoying because it had these like mini pixels, so I had to rely on the wiki. I later then realized that those mini pixels are half a pixel. And apparently it's about average size. Good job, Minecraft. Alright, now I'm gonna suddenly change my editing styles. Enjoy this. For the tools, we'll be using the weird item frame rule as well, and for my fellow Imperial System users, the average sword is 1 kilogram or 2.2 pounds, so not too bad. So first, let's look at the classic sword, which is about 77 pixels of material and 7 pixels of wood.
So now we divide by 32 cubed to get meters cubed, and multiply by the density of wood to get our stick weight of 170 grams. So after using the same method on the material, we get these. Wood is 2 kilograms, stone is 4, iron is 18, diamond is 8, gold is 46, and netherite is 189. How I got the average weight of the netherite scraps was by finding that it floats on lava. Therefore, the density is lower than 3,100. They are also scrap-looking things, which looks like about 25% the volume of a normal ingot. So yeah, each netherite ingot is about 4 times the weight of gold, plus a little bit of extra. Now let's talk about the iron ingot. This thing has a magical property and it changes its density, depending on the tool being made. And the tool with the highest material efficiency, meaning P divided by number is at its highest, is the sword. So that means I calculated all those other pixels for nothing? Yes. Okay, since an iron ingot is 1/9 of a block, this means that the iron gets compressed to 47 the original volume. This compass has a diameter of more than 1 foot. This bundle can hold about 0.165 meters cubed, and with it being able to hold 64 items, that means that each block takes up 1% of a mini voxel. Now that is some serious Okay, so for the spyglass, I thought I'd go a bit deeper for this one. You see, each magnifier has something called a focal length, which is basically the power of the lens, and I'm gonna calculate this, and then simulate it in Blender. Okay, so the magnification of a magnifying glass is a huge, like, dumpster fire. It's literally the most confusing thing I've ever seen in my entire life. So I'm just gonna test out random values in Blender and try to get the same results. So I've set up my little test scene, and I'm gonna replicate this in Blender. So I modeled my thing and my lens, then got to work. Insert montage, but I forgot to record. After all that, I finally ended up with a value of f equals 6.7 centimeters, which by the way is very little for cameras and stuff. And let's take a look. Oh, that's unfortunate. Also, this model is very wrong, because if the spacing was correct, then the thing would be very small. So I just made it a bit closer while retaining the size of the lens, and got this extreme lens distortion. Okay, let me just try to fix that in post. Okay. Besides that, the brush is 1 foot and 3 inches long. The fishing rod is actually normal and actually kind of small for some people. The bow is actually also very small and more than 2 times smaller than what the pros use. However, the arrow's normal size, which is still a whole meter long though, so go archers. Okay, to be honest, most of the Minecraft structures are made up, but some are actually pretty similar to real life things, like the ships, pyramids, igloos, geodes, icebergs, and the fossils. Okay, so the ship has a length of 28 meters, and I don't know, but this looks slightly similar to the brig. So assuming an even distribution, because I don't know statistics, from 23 to 50 meters, this ship falls in about the 18th percentile of ship length. So yeah. And also, the same goes for these pyramids. The largest one is 130 meters tall, and the Minecraft one is just a mere 10 meters. After these disappointments, we finally arrive at the igloo, which is just about the size of the world's largest igloo. But, apparently, Crystal Cave, Ohio, is apparently the largest geode, at about 10.6 meters. Okay, let's see this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Ha. Okay, so this iceberg is pretty big, right? It can get as big as 42 blocks tall, but, yeah. So, I don't know about that one. Okay, thanks for watching this 20-hour long video. I got a little bit passionate while writing the script, but I think I know the real largest thing in Minecraft. And that's why I think you should watch this video. It's one of my favorites. Smiling emoji.